Hi, I'm Michelle Randall. I am the supervisor at the Palmer Museum of Art store. And today I wanted to share with you an art project that you can do at home with just a few simple ingredients. This is an art project that I like to do in my practice. It's called Cyanotype. And if you're interested in it, we also have a piece available that you can view at the Palmer Museum of Art. So today we're going to be working with the cyanotype process. And cyanotype is one of the original photography processes. As you can see, the solution is always blue. It's a monochromatic process. It was originally used to copy notes, to create images of botanical prints, and of course, even architectural drawings. For your project, we're going to need some solution. And these chemicals can be found in an art supply store or a photography supply store. Of course, you can get those in a catalog. I'll put the links in the video for you. You'll need paper or fabric, even an old book will work, anything that is absorbent, and you'll need something to apply the chemical with. And so let's get started. Another option is to purchase a sunprint kit from an art supply store. The paper arrives prepared and ready to use. They're inexpensive and easy to find. They're a great option for beginners, and if you choose to do this, you can skip the mixing and drying step that I'm about to show you. So now I have my two chemicals mixed as a solution. And when they are mixed separately, they're shelf stable for at least 6 months. But once they are combined, you need to use them within 24 to 48 hours. I'm going to mix both chemicals in equal parts, they're both 150 milliliters, into another cup. Mix them together and apply them to my paper. I like to have the brush strokes appear on my paper, but you can do it however you like. That's all you need to do. I'm going to take this now and I'm going to put it in a dry and dark place. Once this chemical solution dries, it becomes photosensitive and you need to keep it in the dark until you're ready to use it. So while we're waiting for that to dry, we can look at some of the materials that you can use for your photograms. Anything from feathers to different types of weeds, or leaves, or cutout images from a vintage pattern. All right, so now my paper is dry. You can see that it's this nice yellow-green color. It's ready to go. And this is what it looks like when it's unexposed. I'm putting it onto a piece of plexiglass so that when I'm ready to move it, my objects don't move. So I'm just gonna play around with it a little bit. I have a doily, it's opaque. I'm going to put that on. And I'm going to play around with some target bags that I cut out. They're semi-transparent. And I'm going to take this little image that I cut out of a vintage pattern and put it on here. And just throw a couple more opaque items on for some fun. And I'm ready to go. So I'm going to put another piece of plexiglass on top, like I said, to secure it, and pin it in place and put it out in the sun. So I'm going to put this now out in the sun for 45 minutes to an hour. And when it's done, it will be a nice dark blue color. We'll come back and look at that. Okay, so I've had my cyanotype sitting out in the sun for over an hour, and I'm gonna see what it looks like. Taking off my plexiglass. You can see a little bit right here before I put it in the water, and then I'm going to develop it in the water. So I've been rinsing this off for about 5 minutes, and now I'm able to do the big reveal. That's it. So I hope you have fun. Once you start this process, it could be addictive. Enjoy it.